it's time to begin with the first two Pawscar Award categories of the night. First up, we have the Trade Stand of the Year, sponsored by Fosdata.
And the winner is Dorwest Herbs.
Terry Donovan.
Tim Hutchings.
Steve and Seymour.
Windsor Championship Show.
Awards. Firstly, the award for Breeder of the Year. We're looking for those who consistently produce dogs of top quality.
And this year has probably been their best year ever.
Huge respect for Michael Gadsby. He's a dog man through and through. He's an extremely clever breeder. I have a huge amount of respect for him.
Well, it goes without saying, Zena is Breeder of the Year. She's a breeder of dogs.
Did I not read that Zena has now won 800 cc's? Mind-blowing, isn't it, to the average exhibitor that dreams of winning three. They've achieved a remarkable level of success. Chris and Pete Sanderford, along with Claire Lewis, have really taken this breed into the spotlight.
I gave them best in show at Southern Counties, and they've got a youngster coming through equally as good.
They have developed what every conscientious breeder dreams of, and that is an instantly recognisable kennel type.
Ladies and gentlemen, Breeder of the Year is Drakesley. Drakesley.
I'm about to say that.
Yeah, you need to say that.
Drakesley.
And I think she's also one of the judges that really likes dogs.
When you watch her judge, you can see that she really enjoys every moment of it. And she's got such a breadth of knowledge across all seven groups.
A young judge who has had a lot of experience with a big kennel, and that he seems to relate in the method in which and how he judges.
Well, he's got a lifetime's experience in dogs, Derek. And he's been involved with so many top-class dogs himself.
Great judge, appreciated, I think, by an awful lot of people.
But I've known Ken Sinclair around for years and years and years, and he's had some beautiful dogs, so...
Enjoys his judging, he's always got a smile on his face when he's judging.
And the winner is... What a delight, Liz Cartledge.
Most of you will know that I don't make speeches, ever. But tonight is a bit special. I love dogs, I love judging, and I quite like people, especially all those that have voted for me. So thank you.
He scares me to death, and I think the dogs really know he's boss.
Dave is somebody who I actually want to be, because not only is he cool,
manly,
absolutely. He's got more hair than me. No, joking aside, I wanted when I was a little lad and realised they were too strong for me. 30 odd years later, they're still too strong for me.
Lovely family man, loves his grandkids, and he doesn't get come over as that. You think he's sort of gruff exterior, but he's, as I say, he's a big pussycat inside.
You and I'm an old lady. I've seen a lot of dog shows. I don't ever remember that happening before. But it was such a clean sweep, wasn't it? I mean, I can't stop smiling.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me the greatest pleasure to present this award to Outstanding Achievement 2013 for breeding, handling, best in show, reserve best in show, and best puppy in show at Southern Counties this year, something that has never been achieved before, to Mr. Dave Killerly.
I'd like to say thank you to everybody, and what a humbling thing it is to stand up here amongst some great people. Many thanks.
Thank you.
She's utterly fair and gives every dog a chance, makes everybody and their dog feel comfortable.
But she'll also tell you straight and be really honest with you if there was something that she wasn't quite sure about.
And dedicated so much time, of her own time, to people who are the future of dogs.
She is an unsung hero for anybody who's been in dogs since they were a child. She is the epitome of junior handling, she is the epitome of education.
She really is an unsung hero.
So I'm delighted to present the Unsung Hero Award to the lady that has done and does so much for our junior handlers, and that would be Liz Cartley.
I think I am speechless now. Not usually, but tonight, yes. One was a big thrill. This one is a bigger thrill, perhaps, for me, because we go back a long way, all these kids. You were one, she was one. There's several in the audience here with children of their own. And, well, it gives me a lot of pleasure to do what I do. So thank you again.
Thank you.
The pedigree dog show world has gone through some tough times in the last few years, and sometimes we haven't been quick enough to defend this wonderful sport. All of us in this room try our very best to produce happy, healthy examples of our pedigree breeds, spending many hours and many pounds in doing so.
So now is your chance to keep the doubters and skeptics quiet by continuing the goodwill we all know we are capable of. Welcome to the Peekaboo Trust.
Combination of all the hard work that everybody put into Jilly Jolly John, and we're here today to give the money to three charities. So the grand total is £49,000. So yeah, really, really good, and I know for a fact that it'll be put to good use.
So as a hospital, we rely on the generous donations of the public to ensure that we can continue to treat and to care for some of the smallest and sickest children in the UK. And each year we see 200,000 patient visits. Wow. And a donation of that size is phenomenal.
We've just had a tour around Great Ormond Street Hospital, and it was quite emotional. You knew what the money was going towards, but after seeing the struggle that families go through, how do you feel now?
I don't think we realise the scale of this place. I think we know it's big, but you have no idea really the amount of people that are here, and so it's amazing to be able to see where it's actually going.
And Gavin, being a father yourself, that must have been tough wandering through those wards.
Yeah, it's actually quite emotional, to be honest. Makes you more grateful and thankful that, you know, I've got two happy, healthy kids at home. But I think probably more so, kids have been well looked after, obviously, but it's the families and the siblings that they've got to deal with it on a daily basis. So I mean, they've shown us around, and we've been in the chapel, which was just leaves a lump on your throat. It actually makes it so gratifying that we've raised that sort of money, and you can see what's going to happen with it. We kind of, yeah, we all know what the hospital does, etc. But when you're here,
you know, you think, oh my God, you know.
Humbling, isn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. A perfect sort of closure to the whole event.
I'd just like to thank Amelia Siddle, who sadly can't be here tonight, for helping me so much on that walk. Without her, it would have been even tougher, so thank you, Amelia. The aim of the Trust is to raise money for children and dog charities. Tonight is a prime example where all the profits of the evening will go into this Trust. The events may be small and local, but every penny will be distributed to worthy causes. I fulfilled a boyhood dream last year, and on Sunday night, it will be someone else who can live the dream. However, none of this would have been possible without friends like you, an amazing wife and children. They put up with hours of me planning or doing something like this and the jaunt. So enjoy the rest of the evening, everybody, and every penny we raise tonight will go to a good trust. Thank you. What have you done today? Come make a feel.